Well, you may have heard KARE 11 is embarking on a year-long project to follow students at Lucy Laney Community School in North Minneapolis. So why this school? Why this neighborhood? Because by many measures, there is something magical going on here. For more than a decade, students here have performed far below state and federal education standards. 90% live in poverty, and countless others face struggles many people can't begin to understand. But how about this? Under the leadership of the school's principal, this same school has now gained on the state standardized tests 3 years in a row. And tonight, we'd like to introduce you to the woman at the helm of this long-awaited shift. A woman who suffered a painful past in the very same neighborhood she's helping to build a brighter future. Here's photojournalist Ben Garvin and Lindsay Sievert with her story.
Good morning, Laney family. It is currently 68 degrees out. On the lunch menu for today, we have roasted turkey breast with gravy and mashed potatoes.
How was lunch? I wish when I was little we had turkey and gravy.
I wish I would be just like you.
You do?
This is a very emotional place for me. That was our apartment. There was a whole full family that lived on the first floor. No matter the pain, I will always be thankful to my mom for keeping me. Now, the things that happened after that, they made me who I am today. But there were years that I could not drive through this neighborhood. The house that we lived in, I was there some of the time, but I was a lot of the time with other people. So there's one house on the block, their house was a refuge for me. But there was also a polar opposite from their house to another house that was a very dark house. And to think that what they allowed or what they did to children in that house and me being one of those children is still a difficult pill for me to swallow to this day. Do you know who I was most angry with was God. That's who I was most angry with. Because to me, my mom did not have the capacity, even I knew. She didn't have the capacity to change my circumstances, but I always thought he did. The things that they did to me or watched do to me are things that they'll have to deal with in life. Anyone would expect someone like me who went through that to be broken, unhealable, damaged goods that will never overcome, never survive, and definitely never be successful. And so I feel like every morning when I stand in front of the kids, I am laughing in the face of that.
High second grade.
That didn't break me, and that now I can provide a bridge or a gap to any child that may be experiencing the same thing.
She does have a lot of love for us. If somebody gets suspended, she supports them. If they lost a family member, she supports them.
Yep, she is nice and she kind. Every day, she nice and kind.
She like treats you like her child and like a second mother.
I feel happy every time I see her. So, so happy.
So when I got the assignment for Lucy Laney, I was like, wow, God. I mean, of all the places in North Minneapolis that I could be, why would you have me, you know, a stone's throw away from some of the most difficult childhood experiences. But I also know that that was very purposeful. It's not a coincidence that I'm back. I don't know how I even got here. I don't even know that I should have been able to have children. I have two beautiful daughters. Any time anybody sees a child, right? A child that looks forlorn, lost, not taken care of, spread your arms, scoop them up, ask questions later, but love them first. Like, that was not the end of my story. It was not, this happened, therefore. It was, this happened, therefore.
She makes this school like the best school in the world. This is like my favorite school that I've ever been to. I've been to a lot of schools.
She greets us every morning, says, how are you doing? What was your weekend like?
Welcome back. I missed you so much.
And then I love that because there's someone in the world that really cares about people like us.
Welcome back. Did you miss me?
Kind of a little bit.
Because we're Northside and people might think that we're just bad and stuff and we're not smart, we're not intelligent. But other people who think inside like Miss Melander really loves us. She knows what kind of kids we are.
I knew it. We knew that was going to be a beautiful woman.
Oh, my.
And a beautifully told story. And we are following that school for a year, kind of documenting a year in the life of Lucy Laney. And I'm so glad now, while we do that, we'll know what an extraordinary woman they have at the helm.
Because I know that, I think, right, that they just, they found this out while they were covering. And they said they have to tell the story because obviously it's a pinnacle part of that school.
Yeah.
I've been here 34 years. I'm not so sure I've seen a more powerful story that we have put on our air than that one tonight.
Yeah, and remember, she's the principal that gave that speech at the beginning of the
day.
Yes,
I do remember.
Protests were going on in the fourth precinct about how beautiful and wonderful those kids are in that school, and to not forget that.
Amazing.
So, yeah.
Really, wow. We have some beautiful pictures. You know, we don't